Hello students, welcome to the class. Today I will discuss with you about law of reflection. So here there are two types of laws in this. One is law of reflection, that is said to be about angle of incidence and angle of reflection relation, and one more is plane of reflection. So what is here a plane of reflection? That means simply here incident light ray, reflected light ray, as well as the normal, all these are lie in the same plane. So here we'll show that with the same activity only. So first I will discuss with you about the first law of reflection, that is angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So for this we need to conduct one small activity here. So what is that activity? What are the materials are needed here? So the materials are needed here, one mirror strip, simply one white paper and pencil, scale, eraser, protractor, etc. So these are the minimum required materials, and if you have possibility to use a laser light, you can use. Otherwise we can verify with a small twigs or small threads. It is also possible with them. Then here first you have to take a paper strip and draw a line on it horizontally, then name that line as A and B. Now identify the midpoint on the AB line, you can name it as M. Then place a mirror strip vertical to the page I shown here. So place on that line vertically, then name that mirror as M and M dash. Midpoint here give as something XYZ anything. So here I am giving as a midpoint as something L here. Then now place the protractor as shown in this screen. Then identify the angles. So they are here 0 to 90 degrees between as 30 degrees, 45 degrees, as well as 60 degrees. So you have already 90 degrees line here, as well as right side also identify that points. But here that points identify them as X, Y, Z, and 90 degrees as N. So don't go for another side of the 90 degrees line here. So one side only we remembered them as X, Y, Z, and N. So another one we will give as X dash, Y dash, Z dash, so on. So here three angles recognized, including 90 degrees here. So totally 4, 30, 45, 60, and 90 degrees, and identified them as X, Y, Z, and N. Now just draw a line to join X point with point L. So name that line as X L. Then here, as similarly here you did to join X and L, similarly join Y, L, Z, L, N and L. So don't go for the right side now. Here, what happens when we incident the light along with these paths? Just we have to identify that. So select your laser light. So here I am going to use here rays, light rays, along with this paths. Then when the light ray meets the mirror surface, what happens? So according to the reflection, it bounces back from the point of incidence. So here for all the rays I am going to use the point of incident here, L point only. So first I will use the light ray to focus at L along with the path X L. So here when the light ray meets the point L on the mirror, so here from there it will reflect back. So that light reflects as you see here. So here now we have to measure the angle between the normal and the reflected light ray. Then here after measuring that, you have to note down the angle here, then just compare that angle made by the incident light ray with the normal, as well as angle made by the reflected light ray with the normal. than what you can observe just not up. So here, according to this observation in this activity, we will say that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So you are measured that angle of incidence is here, angle of incidence measured between the normal and with the path of a light ray, so incident light ray, but not to measure the angle between the AB line and the XL. So it is not the incident angle, angle between the XL and the NL line. So that is the angle of incidence. So angle of incidence is here 60 degrees. So here right side reflected ray is observed as L X dash. So that also made the angle with the line LN or NL is 60 degrees. So from this we can realize that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So similarly, what you followed the process, so continue that along with the paths YL, ZL as well as NL. So one more I will show you here along with ZL. So it is making the angle with the normal line that is NL with reflected light ray is 30 degrees angle. So incident the light ray, then trace the path of reflected light ray, then measure the angle of reflection. So here also you will find out that a reflected angle is 30 degrees. So from this also you can realize that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So here you may ask me about that law of reflection is valid for any way. So here it is valid in case of any mirror that is here, maybe plane surface or maybe the curved surface. So it should be smooth polished surface, so it can be valid. So angle of reflection is equal to angle of incidence, or angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection will be verified here. Then what about this law in case of spherical mirrors, is it valid or not? So you can verify that with using spherical mirrors also, but in this spherical mirrors you need to have knowledge about tangent and the perpendicular drawn at the point where the tangent is going to coincide or meet with the curved line. So I will explain about that in the next class. Thank you.